Hi, I'm Jesse, and I'm here because I might need your help. I'm thinking about replacing a few windows in my house, and I'm considering a few different materials: glass, plastic, and wood. Which one do you think might be the best? For my new windows, I'm choosing between three different materials: glass, plastic, and wood. So let's think for a bit. Well, glass and plastic are both transparent. That means light can pass through, so you can see through it. Is wood transparent? No, wood is definitely not transparent. Now, glass could shatter or break if it was hit with a hard object, such as a baseball. Plastic could also crack or become damaged if it was hit. Wood is probably the strongest of the materials. Yeah, it's a bit more durable. Now, also, glass does not really bend or flex. Plastic and wood could bend or bow or flex if we maybe had some high winds near my house. Also, glass is probably heaviest for its size, a bit heavier than plastic or wood. We just came up with a lot of qualities or things we can observe and measure about glass, plastic, and wood. Qualities that we can observe and measure about different materials are called properties. Knowing or observing the properties of different materials can help us make the best decision when we are choosing what material to use for a certain job. A job like new windows for me. So, thinking about the materials and the properties of the materials that we talked about, which do you think is best? Glass, plastic, or wood? I think we should definitely consider glass or plastic, because these were the transparent materials. Remember, light can pass through glass or plastic, and well, it's very important to be able to see through a window. So how do we know the properties of materials? Well, we can use our senses to make observations. What senses do you think we can use? We could use our eyes to look at something. That would tell us things like the color or the size, or if it looks shiny or dull. We could use our ears to hear something, perhaps by giving it a little tap. We could also use our noses to smell. That would tell us if something smells sweet or maybe it smells smelly. Oh, and of course we could use our hands to find out a little bit about the texture of something. Yeah, we would know if it felt smooth or rough or soft or hard or slippery. We could even try squeezing something to see if it changed shape or stayed the same shape. For some observations, we will need tools to measure properties. We might need a scale to measure the mass of an object, a measuring stick to know how long or wide or tall something is, a thermometer to know how hot or cold a material is. We may even need to do some experiments to test materials. Does the material float or sink? What happens when you heat the material up? What happens when you put the material in the freezer? What happens if I put the material in water and stir? Will it dissolve? Stay the same? Change shape? Now, let's think about the properties of some different materials I have here. As you see, I have a piece of paper, a trash bag, and a blanket. And I need to find something that will protect me from the rain. Well, let's think. If I'm holding it over my head to protect me from the rain, I want something that's nice and light. Well, the trash bag is very light, and the piece of paper is very light. The blanket is probably the heaviest one. But it's also important that it's waterproof. Yeah, I certainly need a waterproof material, and something that's waterproof is usually shiny and hard. So, this piece of paper is not very shiny and not very hard either. The blanket is not shiny and very soft. This trash bag is not very hard, but it is shiny. And I think this will be my best bet. Thank you for helping me make some decisions about what materials to use for my windows and for my umbrella. Yeah, I'm sure I'll have some real nice windows and a pretty good umbrella. Yeah, well, now it's your turn to go pick out some materials for the job that you have. And remember to think about the properties of each material. Have fun, and remember to always be clever.